and welcome back to Homeschooling HQ. Don't forget to go and subscribe to our social media. Today we're going to look at some fun ways of getting our children writing again and increasing their motor skills. So let's get on with it.
So do some sandpaper letters. Now, if you've got a sheet of sandpaper, put some patterns on there. Just using a bit of, I've used the oil pastels, but it can use crayons or anything. I put them on there, I put some letters, I put some shapes, and now I've got some string. And what I get the children to do is to try and create those shapes using the string. And the great thing is the sandpaper itself takes hold of the string, so it kind of, you know, doesn't come off. It's great for getting those motor skills working. And also, if you're using letters, obviously children just recognising the shapes of the letters. A bit more difficult than you realise. So you can do it with lots of different shapes, lots of different letters. Get them to do it over and over again. You can use wool, I suppose, a little string. And as I say, it sticks to the sandpaper.
Now moving on from our sandpaper letters, I've got some big bits of paper here. Again, I've just put some shapes on there. And I've got some letters on there, and I'm going to do some what's known as rainbow letters. So I'm going to take lots of different colours, and I get the children to go back over the sheet.
So I've done it in red, but then I get them to do it in a different colour. So again, tracing it or going around that sheet with the different colours. And you can use any media like pastels or felt tips or crayons, chalk. For example, I can use this one with felt tip. Again, it's just getting them used to those shapes. And then you can keep doing this until, like a nice rainbow pattern.
So I'm just gonna do a letter now. This time I'm using chalks. Again, just gets them used to doing those shapes of the letters. And again, you can try that with any letters, any shapes, any patterns. Now another way of doing that is by drawing out your shapes of your letters with a marker. I've just used pink and green. And then again, getting them to trace over the actual shape of that with a black pen or another pen. And the marker they can see quite clearly. Having to do that a little bit. Neater, trying to stay in those lines. And again, you do this with all different shapes, all different letters. You don't have to be that big, you can be a bit smaller.
Now moving on from there, we can just simply trace the letters again, using any different media. So we've got felt tips, using those for the shapes. Similar activity, but then I might move on to things like using cotton buds with paints, just a bit of fun. Whee. Or normal paint brushes. Or big thick markers. Anything you can get your hands on. Now with any sort of writing, children need that role model. So writing a shopping list, making sure that they're involved in it and the value of an actual writing activity. So, you know, it's not all just done by memory, that writing is a valuable activity.
So as I said, make sure that you are a role model for their writing. Practice all these different things, use lots of different media, lots of different ways, get those motor skills up and running, and the children will be writing before you know it. Thanks for joining me into Homeschooling HQ, and we'll see you next time. Bye now.